guys, what's up? It's Joe Rady from Rady's Rides. I'm here at this undisclosed location because guess what? I have a brand new, totally redesigned 2020 Kia Soul. This one though is finished off in that GT line trim. What that means is with the GT line, underneath this hood is turbocharged horsepower, turbocharged fun. But let's talk a little bit about the Kia Soul. Kia Soul, that funky, cool little compact SUV, little compact crossover utility vehicle, first came out on the scene all the way in 2009, believe it or not. Now, during that time, there was a lot of competition from other manufacturers making these boxy, quirky cars. You had the Scion XB, you had the Nissan Cube, and the Honda Element. Well, guess what? All of those have fallen to the wayside, and Kia has found the secret sauce in making such a fun, affordable, quirky car that has a lot of usability out of it. Fast forward to 2020, wait until you see the interior of this thing, wait until you see underneath the hood and we take it for a spin. It's gonna blow you away what Kia is able to do. This car was designed here in the United States over at the studios in California where Kia is based out of. Kia Motor Cars USA is based out of over in that state. So let's go ahead, dive in and see what's different for 2020. Right off the bat, I love the aggressive styling on this thing. I never thought I would say aggressive in a Kia Soul, but you can see very, very slim LED lighting, really great design. You have this large area down here with fog lamps, and as we come across this large mouth grille, really gives it a sinister look. I mean, this is something that it makes you say, hey, does this thing have some power? And guess what it does? I like that GT line badge right here, perfect placement. And I really like the brushed aluminum design to the grill here. It's like a gloss black with these little designs that are all brushed aluminum. Nice lower lip spoiler that's integrated. And I think this red trim is really spot on, especially with the GT line. You could see the large openings above the grille in the front fascia. Remember, this car 1.6 liter turbocharged intercooled. So we want to get maximum flow to the front of the car and to that intercooler. But it's very smart how they did the styling. Now coming up onto the hood, you can see that there's a recessed body line in the hood to give it some nice personality. Love the style of the Kia badge blacked out with the chrome. I think that that is the best way to go with that badge to really give it a nice quality upscale look. Now, as we come around the bend, these are going to be specific wheels for the GTN line. So I love the finish on them. You have this dark gunmetal gray. I like the brushed aluminum, 18 inch wheel. This vehicle is front wheel drive. So all the power is going to go through a DCT 7-speed and get to these front wheels. But I love the style, and you can see just the little touches, the red that goes with the red trim at the front. Now, as we go into the fender, really digging this body line, very strong, powerful line in the fender, and then also in this portion that leads us into the door. Now, what I really, really think is great here is that they took the white, brought it onto the mirror. You got the nice slim and trim LED. They blacked out the A-pillar. Really gives it a look to where the roof even looks lower than what it is. And you can see I'm 6 feet tall and very good. You know, if you wanted to put some roof rails and some crossbars, you could easily be carrying around a kayak and get it up there very easily. Down below, more great body lines. This car, I'm telling you, where they place these body lines were so spot on. Love the red trim as we work our way back. Very cool design. Now, one area that I wish that they would have done, maybe there's an option I would have to check, but if this whole roof was blacked out, I really think that that would just give it an even more sporty look. So that would be, I'm not going to zonk it, but that is something that I would like to have, a blacked out roof on the GT line. Now, as we come to the back, you can see how the rear has almost like a floating roof design with the black that they brought into this rear quarter. You got the sole embossed right there on that back area. There's more of that great body line action. And as we spin it around the back here, you can see the direction that they went in with the restyle. Now, one area I'm gonna zonk, I'm not really digging the way that they brought the lighting all the way up here. Now, this whole thing does not light up. The third brake light is integrated in there, but I wish it was body, the same color as the body or that black roof design, because what I would like to see on the GT line is a low roof spoiler come off the back just a little bit. I think that that would really look great with the overall flow of the vehicle. But I like the way that they took the gloss black, kind of separated this back portion, and then really they hit the nail on the head. If you wanted a sporty rear end to a Kia Soul, I love the twin exhaust outlets on the GT line. This rear diffuser area, there's our badge. And another thing that I love, which normally I don't say this, are these fake vents. They're not functional, but what I like about it is that they took the actual non-functioning part and pushed it deep inside there, kind of recessed it to where it gives it a really clean look. But from front to back, it still holds those distinctive lines of being a Kia Soul. So let's go ahead, pop the hood, and check out that turbocharged fun. All right, guys, we got the hood popped on the 2020 Soul GT line. What you're looking at is that 1.6 liter turbocharged inline four. Now, at the end of the day, when we're talking about power, you're looking at 201 horsepower, 195 pound-feet of torque. It's all mated through a very slick shifting seven-speed DCT. Yes, you heard me correct, not a CVT, a seven-speed DCT. 0 to 60 in this thing, 6.5 seconds, quarter mile if you could believe it, 15 seconds flat at almost 94 miles an hour. It actually weighs about 3,123 pounds. And probably the best part is you're gonna get 27 miles to the gallon in the city and 32 on the highway. So with this car, you could basically have it all. You could have something that's gonna stand out with fun, quirky looks. There's really no better way to say it than that. The power, and also wait until you see the inside, all the great tech. Before we get to that though, let's fire up this GT line Kia Soul and see what does it sound like. All right, guys, here we are sitting in the 2020 Soul. I'm telling you right now, they did an amazing job with the setup on this interior. Now, I know you're probably saying, Joe, I'm liking what I'm seeing so far. What's the price? MSRP, this thing is basically fully loaded. You're looking at around $29,000. You know what? You're going to be surprised because there's a lot you get. Let's go to the door panels. Now, one of my favorite things with the door panels is that they broke up the sea of dark black with some really cool color to it, kind of bringing that reddish orange trim into the interior of the car. Harman Kardon system, over 600 watts, great sound. I love the armrest, nice and soft with some contrast stitching, looks really clean, very 21st century. As we go from the door panel to the dash, soft material, just like on that door panel, soft material. You can see the gloss black, the tweeters built into the dash here, really cool design. And then right here, this infotainment system is spot on. First of all, this is a 10.3 inch screen, massive. You could see that you could have navigation, your XM or whatever radio station you're listening to, and weather forecast. As you can see, we've been dancing in between the raindrops here, I promise you that. Really easy to use, and I'm telling you, so clear, no glare, wonderful setup. Really, I think they hit the nail on the head. I like the way it's a little bit tilted towards the driver. You do have an auto dimming mirror. I wish it was frameless, but that's okay. Dual climate control, easy to use, very, very clear. You have your wireless charging pad here, USB, 12 volt, another USB, heated seats, heated steering wheel, different drive modes. Here's where your start stop button is. This is gonna shift that seven speed DCT transmission. Love the red contrast stitching. I wish that they would have took some of this material and put it on the actual e-brake, but hey, I like the fact that it's got a real e-brake, two cup holders, wonderful height armrest. It's a little on the hard side, so I am gonna zonk that, but wonderful height. Open it up, you got tons of great space in there, and these seats. I love the leather, I love the red stitching. Really nice fabric. It's very durable, but it looks good. That's what I like about it. And they're very comfortable and supportive. I'm 6 feet tall, plenty of headroom, even with the sunroof, and just feel like I could drive forever in this thing. Why don't you come over to the business end and I'll show you behind the wheel, because I'm telling you, there's some nice
things going on over here. Come on over.
All right, guys, behind the wheel of the Kia Soul GT line, you do have full electric assist for the driver. Really great, comfortable seat. You could really form it to your body. Steering wheel. This is one of my favorite things about this car. They are on the money. Love the thickness, the red contrast stitching, and the crisscross pattern. Flat bottom, nice GT line logo here with the brushed aluminum. Like I said, I think the Kia logo in black with the white outline and everything, it's on the money. Little bit of gloss black, I like it. It's funky, it's cool. Even the controls have a nice different style to them and whatnot. So I really like that. Gauge setup, very clean, very easy to read. So you have a digital display in the center. You got two different modes, sport and normal. Right now I have it in sport. Analog tach, analog speedometer. Let me show you something that Kia does that's genius. When you turn on the windshield wipers, look how it actually shows you what mode you're in. I like that. You don't have to look at the actual stalk coming off the steering column. You could look right there. Those are nice touches where you know that they thought it through. Let me show you another thing on top of the dash. First of all, up here above the gauge cluster, I like the hood, the way it's got the red stitching. Check this out. I press a button. It's got actual heads-up display. The screen pops up. So if you want to use heads-up display, you press that button and it comes up. This thing has lane keep assist, blind spot monitoring, all the technology to keep you safe in it. And at the end of the day, turbocharged power. What else can we say? One area, though, that I am going to zonk it is I wish they would have gave us aluminum pedals. It would have been nice touch to have an aluminum brake pedal and aluminum gas pedal for the GT line. But other than that, it's on the money. Let's go ahead and check out the back seat and see how comfortable it is for your passengers. All right, guys, back seat time of the Soul GT line. I tell you, they have done their homework. For being in basically a compact crossover utility vehicle, lots of room here. I'll say it again, 6 feet tall, plenty of headroom. I feel comfortable, spacious. I like the way it's got a nice pocket on the back of the seat. I'm not a big fan of the plastic, but I know some of you are, especially if you have children, but that would have been nice if it was all leather. You do have a USB, which is great. No rear AC, but you know what? At this price point, I think you're getting a lot of other nice amenities. It would be nice, so we'll give that a half zonk to not have the AC back here. You do get, though, a very, very nice armrest, soft, two cup holders, flip it back, leather with that wonderful cloth material and the red stitching. You can't recline the seat really, but you know what? When it comes to folding it down, you'll see when we do the cargo area in a second, there's a lot of room in here. Class leading. Let's go ahead, check out that cargo area. I think it's about time. All right, guys, tail end of the business. Let's see what kind of junk can we put in the cargo area of a Kia Soul. Very soft, easy to use, rear hatch, lots of space. Now, what's cool is that this little security shade can be easily flipped up, which is really nice. Once you look inside, though, you actually have one of those movable floors. So it's in the low position, but if you notice, I'll have O'Neill show you that there is a part there, a shelf, that you could actually bring the floor back in the back of the vehicle up to another second level. There's a 12 volt, you have LED lighting, and what's really great is that these seats are easy to fold down. You just pull up on that little lever and the seats are gonna go down. Look at how much space. Now remember, because there's a gap, it's just because I have the floor in the fold down position. I have a bunch of my junk from filming today back here, just to give you an idea that there's plenty of other room, but this floor can come up and it isn't totally flat, but it's not too shabby when you're looking at from back of the cargo area all the way to the back of the passenger and driver's seat. But I think it's about that time. If you're ready, I'm ready. Let's go ahead and take this Kia Soul GT line for a spin.
All right, guys, we're inside the 2020 Kia Soul GT line. We're now going to take it for a spin. Really, really comfortable in here. I'm telling you right now, this is such a versatile vehicle. It's unbelievable. It kind of does a little bit of everything, and there are some things it does extremely well. One of those things is interior space. Nicely done. I'm going to go ahead and get on the brakes. Turn it into this right-hand bend. It is a little wet out, so we're gonna take it gingerly, but on throttle, really, I'm telling you, the DCT in this is a very quick shifting gearbox, and you know what? The feedback that you get from the front wheels is pretty, pretty good. I'm gonna go ahead and put it in sport mode, which when I put it in sport mode, that's gonna adjust how the shifts are in the transmission. It's also gonna give me a boost gauge and whatnot on the dash, just to let me know what the turbo's doing and whatnot. But even through this little section here of twisty bit, nice feedback coming from the front and the rear of the vehicle. Would I like a little bit more? Sure, but you know what? They definitely have raised the bar when it comes to the compact crossover utility SUV segment. Steering wheel, though, is one of my favorites, period, out of any car. They've really got the thickness and the shape and everything about it is perfect when it comes to a steering wheel. Visibility, it's really nice in here. Out the front windshield, beautiful. Back window, great. Side mirrors work great. Now, what's kind of cool that I didn't point out earlier is with that Harman Kardon sound system, this has the LED lighting that lights up that goes with the beats of the music. Now, I can't really show it during the day, but at night, it is a little bit of a light show that you can have in the interior of the car. Nothing that's going to cause you to have issues while you're driving, but just to add a little funkiness to the interior since the outside has that funky feel to it. Dash is so easy to see and read. I like the black gauges with the white letters. It's all backlit LED, so it's super sharp and clear. This 10.3 inch screen, it's almost like a drive-in movie theater. Unbelievable, the size and the fact that there's absolutely no glare on it, which is great. I like the lighter headliner, really allows the interior to feel even more open than what it was. My only zonks, really, is just a little hard on this armrest. The door armrest is actually nicely padded. This one's a little bit on the harder side. Other than that, I guess I would like full leather seats. That would have been nice, maybe especially at the price point of $29,000. But other than that, this is actually a surprising vehicle. And if you've never driven one, I highly recommend giving it a go because it's going to surprise you, especially if you're looking for that perfect daily driver that just has the right quirks to it and the usability. I mean, you saw the cargo space back there and how you could reposition everything. Really, really wonderful setup. Quiet inside, smooth. I guess ventilated seats would be a nice extra touch, but you know what? I'm not gonna get too greedy overall. To put it into manual shift mode, you take the shifter and you slide it over. Now, the zonk with that is I don't like going up to go up the gears. I like it the other way, where you pull back to go up the gears and then push forward to go down the gears. But you do have these wonderful paddles on the steering wheel. They're a great size, and even though they're not metal, they don't feel like cheap plastic, which is really great. All right, guys, I have it in manual mode. I'm gonna drop it down to second gear on throttle. I tell you, man, this thing pulls very surprisingly, and the shifts have a great feel. Every time you hit the next gear, it gives you a great jolt, which is nice as they're engaging. And even on the downshifts, very, very smooth. I don't know if you heard that whirling sound. That's all coming from the front of the car. So you're gonna get this great sound, which makes the drive even more fun. And that's, this car is an enthusiast car. That GT line is an enthusiast car with this powertrain and the way that it's trimmed out. But let's see how she handles through these twisty bits here. So second gear on throttle. On the brakes. So you are getting some really cool sounds from the front of the car. I would like a little bit more when it comes to feedback to the wheel. I would like a little bit more feedback. There's something getting a little lost in translation with the electric steering rack in this car. So I would like to see a little bit more work on that, especially like, I think it would have been cool to have, if you put it in sport mode, then what it does is it actually gives a little bit more weight to the steering wheel. I think that would have been a nice feature to add to switching it over to sport mode. But still very planted. And, you know, if this car was all-wheel drive, forget about it. It would be ridiculous. But very impressed with how the DCT in this Kia, it shifted very quickly, whether you're going up or down the gears, which is really nice to see. All right, guys, we're going to do an acceleration test from a dead stop on throttle. You actually get wheel spin in this thing. Unbelievable. Third, fourth, on the brakes. Feels great. Tight right-hander. Throttle down, power down, shifts hit nicely. Now I've noticed that you do get some torque steer, and when you're exiting a turn, if you're too aggressive with the throttle, it is gonna push. What that means is the car is gonna slide the opposite direction than what you're trying to turn. But you just gotta be a little gingerly with throttle. Once you do that, then she just grips and goes. Through this interchange here on the brakes. Nice. Great feedback. Just wish it was a little bit heavier, a little bit heavier steering. And I don't mean that in a negative way, like I need a heavy wheel or something. It just, I want some more feedback. So that would perfect the whole process here. All right, guys, we're gonna do one last little bit of twisty bits here. Here we go, on throttle, third gear. The brakes, downshift. Really nice. I mean, overall, this is crazy that I'm in a Kia Soul having this much fun. On the brakes, third gear, second gear. Like I say, you just gotta be a little gingerly with the throttle, on throttle. Really drives very nicely, super smooth. Even over these bumps and whatnot, you're not getting a lot of bang or anything like that. It's absorbing the bump and keeping you comfortable and making you feel like you're in control. That's the great thing, because sometimes, you know, with a higher center of gravity, you sort of feel like you're wallowing all over the place, but not with this. You just gotta be, like I said, mindful about the torque steer and the push that you're gonna get in a turn if you're carrying too much speed and you try to be a little aggressive with the throttle. It's gonna overpower those tires. But I think for compromises, Kia did a great job with the overall drivability of this car, and just rock solid. It's quiet in here, no cracks or creaks or anything like that. But we're gonna go ahead and wrap this up, get back to our undisclosed location, and I'll see you in a split second.
All right, guys, been a fun day with this 2020 Kia Soul GT line. Definitely got to thank Kia Motors for allowing me to have access to their press fleet and bringing, this is the first Soul that we brought to Rady's Rides. So expect more to come from Rady's Rides and Kia Motors. So thank you, everybody at Kia Motors. If these are the types of things that you like to see on Rady's Rides, leave a comment in that comment section. If you're new to the channel and you're on your way out, hit that subscribe button. I promise you it's worthwhile coming back for more. If you are a subscriber, thank you for being part of the Rady's Rides family. If you want to help us keep making great content just for you here on Rady's Rides, click the link in the description. Takes you right to Spreadshirt. Every little bit helps. Speaking of every bit, I'm telling you, O'Neill has upped his game. He's working the camera like a champ, getting this Kia Soul perfect for you guys. He's determined, he's willing and able. So thank you, O'Neill, for all your hard work. And just like always, guys, I'll see you on the next ride.